I'll go upstairs and check this.
Sure. Don't be my hairdryer.
I'll go tell him.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Hearts to Heaven, LSB 477. The expanded Easter hymn section in Lutheran Service Book contains Beethoven's familiar tune, Hymn to Joy, which well supports this Easter text and helps express the glad victory of our Lord's resurrection. Like the vast majority of hymns in LSB, a standard four-part setting is provided for this hymn, making it suitable for singing in parts, as you will hear in this recording.
Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. We are illumined by the brightness of his rising. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Death has no more dominion over us. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Joyous light of glory, of the immortal Father, heavenly, holy, blessed Jesus Christ. We have come to the setting of the sun and we look to the evening light. We sing to God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy of being praised with pure voices forever. O Son of God, O Giver of life, the universe proclaims your glory. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who led your people Israel by a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. Enlighten our darkness by the light of your Christ. May his word be a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. For you are merciful, and you love your whole creation, and we, your creatures, glorify you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let my prayer rise before you as incense, the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice.
O Lord, I call to you. Come to me quickly. Hear my voice when I cry to you.
Let my prayer rise before you as incense, the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. Set a watch before my mouth, O Lord, and guard the door of my lips.
Let not my heart incline to any evil thing. Let me not be occupied in wickedness with evildoers.
But my eyes are turned to you, O God. In you I take refuge. Strip me not of my life. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Let my prayer rise before you as incense, the lifting up of my hands as the evening sacrifice. Let us pray. Let the incense of our repentant prayer ascend before you, O Lord, and let your loving kindness descend on us, that with purified minds we may sing your praises with the church on earth and the whole heavenly host, and may glorify you forever.
Amen.
A reading from 2 Corinthians chapter 5. For we know that if the tent, which is our earthly home, is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this tent we groan, longing to put on our heavenly dwelling, if indeed by putting it on we may not be found naked. For while we are still in this tent, we groan, being burdened, not that we would be unclothed, but that we would be further clothed, so that what is mortal may be swallowed up by life. He who has prepared us for this very thing is God, who has given us his Spirit as a guarantee. In many and various ways God spoke to his people of old by the prophets.
But now, in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son.
Today we have a reading from Day by Day by We Magnify You by Luther, page 408. For we know that if the heavenly dwelling we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. This body is, as St. Paul says, only a tent of the soul, made of earth or clay, and like an old garment. But because the soul is already in new, eternal, and heavenly life through faith, and can neither die nor be buried, we have nothing more to wait for than this poor tabernacle may likewise be made new and incorruptible. For our better part is above, and cannot leave our flesh behind. As he who is called resurrects it, he is risen from the death in the grave, so he who says, I believe, and clings to him must also follow. For he has gone before us that we should follow, and he has begun the work in us, that through his word and baptism we may be daily raised in him. If you receive the word in faith, you are given other eyes that can see through death to the resurrection and apprehend the pure thoughts and image of life. If I would judge according to my reason that I can see and understand, I should be lost. But I possess an understanding loftier than what the eyes can see and the senses feel, which faith has taught me. For there stands the text that says, resurrects it, he is risen, not for himself, but for our sake, that his resurrection may be made ours, that we may also rise in him, and not remain in death in the grave, but with him may celebrate in the body an everlasting Easter. Sermons from the year 1533. We continue with Alleluia, Jesus is Risen, a very familiar tune, and it's nicely words nicely set to that tune for resurrection.
Amen.
Traditional in evening prayer is the canticle, the Magnificat, which is the song of Mary after the angel's announcement to her that she would be the mother of Jesus. The Magnificat serves as a confession of faith for the church. Mary is a leader in confessing the faith of the Lord God using us for his purposes in this world, and then proclaiming our faith and belief in him. Because of that, there are many, many settings of the Magnificat, and so we enjoyed this evening a new setting by the Concordia Seminary Choir, Jesus Christ, Light of the World.
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior.
My spirit magnifies the Lord, my soul rejoices that God came and noticed me of low estate and lifted high my humble name.
For behold, henceforth all generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
His mercy
and exalted those of low degree. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away.
His servant Israel he helped. He kept his
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Matthew, Daniel, John, for all pastors in Christ, for all servants of the church, and for all the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Donald, Mitch, Nancy, John, Eric, James, for all public servants, for the government, and those who protect us, that they may be upheld and strengthened in every good deed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who work to bring peace, justice, health, and protection in this and every place, especially Amy, Chad, Darcy, Dave, Deb, Eve, Laura, Heather, Jessica, Joan, Judy, Kaylee, Kevin, Kyle, Shelley, and Tim, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who bring offerings, those who do good works in this congregation, those who toil, those who sing, and all the people here present who await from the Lord great and abundant mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the members of Faith Lutheran Church and their families, especially Eve, Trent, Heather, Bryce, Jaden, Tyler, John, Darcy, Alex, Jake, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the faithful who have gone before us and are with Christ, let us give thanks to the Lord.
Alleluia.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Rejoicing in the fellowship of the saints, let us commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our Lord.
To you, O Lord.
O God, from whom come all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and also that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Almighty and Merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you.
Amen.
Our closing hymn today will be this wonderful pairing of For All the Saints with Jesus Lead Thou On. It's the rah-rah for all the saints with all the alleluias, and then the Jesus still lead us through this wilderness. And so we rejoice in these good words for us.